Hello, everybody. This is Betrayal at Baldur's Gate, and these are the players.
We love Avalon Hill. Yeah. All
right, this is the first time we played the game, so we're gonna give it a try, and hopefully it'll be okay. All right, let's start. So, Ronnie, you are the first character.
Speaking of things, bringing Eternal.
Oh, yeah, we don't need that anymore.
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay, so what would you like to do? You are player one. You have a speed of
five.
And what is your name?
Tasha Bright Bottle.
All right, Tasha Bright.
I would think I would need more alcohol.
It's a Bright Bottle.
Okay.
What would you like to do?
I get to move five, right?
Yes, you may move five spaces. So, you want to jump right into the catacombs, or do you want to jump right into the city?
No. If I make a new one and then make a new room, do I keep making new rooms?
Well, it depends on what the room is.
Let's see what
so room you're number go
one
there?
Holds. All
right, room number one.
It is a warehouse, and there is a card that looks like a little cow. That is an item card. That means there is something cool there. You have to read what it is, and then you can decide to keep it or not.
A vial of in Baldur's Gate poison. It's a vial of poison. In Baldur's Gate, poison is the most direct way to tell someone you tire of their presence.
Of course it is.
When you inflict physical damage with an attack, you may discard this item to increase that damage by one die plus one. Don't say what size die. Is there only one size
Yeah, there's only one die.
Right.
So if you want to attack, when you're attacking someone and you want to use the vial of poison...
So,
well, some of them that means that's a zero.
Zero. Wow.
So, but it still does one plus whatever's on the poison die. And I assume you would like to keep that.
Yeah.
Okay. So
can
you
walking
now,
or no?
No, you drew a card, so that ends your turn as far as movement. Is there anything else you want to do? You probably don't want to attack anybody. You probably don't want to do
attack the darkness.
Yeah. So you're good. So there. Oh, and this stays face up. Because somebody can try instead of an attack, you can try to steal items from other players.
Nice.
You say you're going to attack them, but instead you say you're attacking them to steal. You do an opposed roll, and if you win, you steal the item.
Yeah, steal things from the rogue. That's a good idea.
Yeah, probably not the best idea. Okay, so who's number two? Oh, no, it continues to the right. It continues to the right after her, so you.
We go backwards.
Yes. Why counterclockwise?
That's wrong.
Just for funsies.
You want to go counterclockwise?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're going.
Yeah, don't go
yellow.
The same direction.
That could have been a mountain.
Boring.
Oh, he found the dead end.
Yep.
Nice.
Don't go near there.
Right. Good job, Danny.
How's it going? The timer is
dead.
It's Baldur's Gate. Oh, but he does get to do an event card. So this is an event that could affect all of us.
I can do this.
What happens?
Hey, shambling porn.
Point of order. You did not have a minute or so. I'm just saying.
Oh, I'm sorry. This is Kevin.
No.
Dadius the Scarlet.
There we go.
Yes.
I'm sorry, what's your name?
Dadius the Scarlet.
Okay. He
might be pronouncing it incorrectly, but that's what
he is. He is a wizard,
today.
I believe.
Yes, we could say that.
Magic missile.
The darkness.
No. Alright, so what happens on the event card?
Shambling form, one more time. A drunkard staggers toward you through the night. As the form draws near.
From where?
From the dead end.
Dead end.
There.
Obviously.
I've invaded his dead end.
This is the door that says, do not enter.
Yeah,
employees only. Okay. Yeah.
What happens?
So what happens when you open
well,
the door?
Well, he's staggering towards me through the night still. As the form draws near, you see to your horror that it's actually a bloated, shambling zombie.
Oh, God.
He just wants a hug.
I must attempt a speed roll.
Okay, so you need to roll the number of dice that it says. Does it say?
No.
Okay, hold on.
Did I roll my speed in dice?
Roll all of them.
I can roll all the dice.
I mean, that's
yes,
four,
but they're
four speed.
I have a four speed.
So,
yeah, be careful.
Many times during the game, you will need to make one roll using one or more dice. There's no limit to how many times a turn you can roll the dice. If a card tile or
keep
other
game until you win.
Hey!
That doesn't sound
okay,
right.
Okay, when that happens, roll the dice equal to the number your adventure currently has in that trait. For example, if you must attempt a sanity roll at plus three, then you and currently have a sanity roll at four, the dice, you have to go under. So does it tell you what the target is?
Yes.
Okay.
If I roll four or better, I dodge a zombie, evading a speed check just before it explodes in a burst of slime and pus.
Okay, so and it's a speed check, right?
Speed roll. I've got a speed of four, so
okay,
I roll
so
four dice.
So you roll four dice and try to get under the number.
Under the number?
No, over the number.
Over the number.
Sorry. That would make more sense.
Yes. Two, three, I tend to sleep, but I'm caught in the shower of gore as a zombie bursts.
Yeah.
Why is he first?
He's a blow up zombie.
He's blowing.
Yeah. He ate too many beans today.
Probably a former patron of the bar.
Questions you don't want to know.
Oh, that looks like a good roll.
Yeah, I got a six.
It's going to be really amusing, so you want to have that on there.
Are we good still?
Yes.
All right.
Do you get anything?
I get a 10-foot pole.
That's why he exploded. Where did he
the zombie
that?
Had a 10-foot pole inside him. The yeah. perfect tool when you want to test something from a safe distance.
Maybe it's he upside was down. Behind him. And his
Sure. It was behind him. Let's leave this behind us.
That sounds worse.
Do you want to
maybe
keep the 10-foot pole?
Dancer.
So this is done, right?
Yep, the bench is done. I will keep the 10-foot pole for now.
Is it a weapon or?
No. If an event card would cause damage to any adventurer within one tile of you, including yourself, you may discard this item to reduce the damage from that event to zero.
So you hit it with the pole.
I push it away.
Yeah, okay, all right.
Like the zombie that was
That's happening. Right. All right, Chris, it is your turn.
Yeah, I don't want to go to the basement by myself, so where else can I go?
You can go into the kitchen, or you can go... Oh, you can, there's two street tiles. You can go back out into the street.
Oh, I don't want to go on the street. No, I'll follow the burglar.
Tasha.
Yes.
Tasha
And
Brightfall.
You are...
I am the purple...
And actually, how many movements do you have?
Five.
Sorry,
I am...
Tasha Balbert?
Avrixis...
Right bottle. Yes.
Right ball?
A drow ranger.
Okay, I have you two moves into the warehouse.
I'm going another one.
Okay, you can go out to a building or a street.
Building.
All right, you go into the building. This one or this one?
I'm going to go towards Val.
Who built this in?
No.
God. Yeah.
This is a building that's Same. A street.
Mm-hmm.
Is that a problem?
No, it only matters,
the color only matters when you're going through the door. Okay. No, nothing else matters.
So now does that mean that they
So this is the shrine to Gagarith and whatever that is. And you got a bird icon, so you draw an omen.
Ooh.
That means we got our first haunt roll.
Call.
Let's see what happens.
Weapon. This dusty tome is filled with secrets, some useful, some dangerous. If you attack an opponent that has a sanity trait, you may attack with sanity instead of might.
Yeah.
The opponent defends with sanity, and the damage is mental instead of physical. If you attack an opponent in this way, and you take damage, take one additional point of damage. You can't use another weapon while you're using this one. Make a haunt roll now.
Okay, then you make the haunt roll, but what is your current might, Chris? On your character.
Crap. Three.
And what's your sanity?
Also three.
Okay, so for you it doesn't matter. Do you want to keep the book for now, or do you want to just leave it where it's at?
I'll keep it for now.
Okay, so he's keeping the book. You moved and you drew a card, so you're done. Unless there's anything else you want to do. You want to try
to make a haunt roll now.
So haunt roll. Yes. Okay, you need to roll the number of dice equal to the number of omens that are in play, which is one, and you have to be under six.
One.
Wow, no haunt!
What?
All right, Mike, your turn.
Okay. So I could drop it and keep going?
You could drop it, but you couldn't keep going because you drew a card. Drawing a card is the only thing that ends your movement.
Well, I'm a dwarf, so I'm going to go to the kitchen.
All right.
I have a four movement.
Okay, two. And you're going to go down to the catacombs?
Yeah, basement, yeah.
Okay, that's a three to go there.
We'll let these people out.
And then you can, you can make it. There's blue doors, right?
Yeah, one more.
I can move one more into one.
Would you like to?
Yeah, I'll go. Yeah, yeah.
All right. Of course he is.
Here you go. Place that in.
They store the good food here.
Yeah. Place that in
the chamber.
Okay. And what?
Wow, the food is really human.
Oh, and another omen card.
It's Soylent Green.
There you go. Good luck.
Soylent Green is people.
Iron flask of tourney. This iron flask shudders and quakes as if something wants out. Instead of attacking normally, you may use this omen on your. Oh, it's an omen.
Mm-hmm.
You may use this omen on your turn to open the flask, unleashing the Baylor demon trapped within.
Good grief.
Ooh, that would be a good idea.
The demon makes a might 6 attack against every adventurer, monster, and NPC on your tile.
Wow! Well, that's, perhaps
let's hope he does not become the
including
traitor.
Including yourself.
Oh my gosh, really?
Yeah. Before returning to the abyss.
Who the heck would do that?
This omen can be used only once per game. Make a haunt roll now.
Okay, so two dice and try to get under six. I assume you're keeping the bottle has it?
John,
I'm a
reckless
equal to six barbarian,
and
so
under,
why wouldn't I use it?
Sure.
Or less than six.
It has to be,
do it near him.
It has to be less than six.
I'm not sure zero accomplishes that.
No, you're zero. Okay, you're good.
Val!
So him, and then we can shove the flask, open it and shove the flask down 10 feet away.
I think we should go in an entirely different direction since we're all so close together. Okay, very, very good.
I follow Ronnie, or whatever,
my
the burglar.
My speed is 4, which means I can
bottle.
Go 1, 2, 3, 4.
To the real kitchen?
You could go there, but nothing would happen because
right.
the
so there is another
there.
Blue door.
But there's another blue door there, yeah. You want to try that?
Yeah, come on, open another door.
I feel like we're very
Munchkin, Munchkin.
It's a valid strategy to stay with the party if you want. It's up to you.
The majority of us are up here on this level.
Just saying. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm moving here.
Oh, okay, so good.
So it's a
executioner's block.
Wow.
Do I have to?
You're supposed to put it in a way that makes it the most buildable.
Are those exits? The other exits?
Yeah, those are the exits.
Okay.
Huh. So yeah. So there you go, and it's got an omen.
Fantastic. We're going to be haunted.
You're going to
so
be haunted
fast.
Real quick. Wow. You guys are good.
I all right. Game ends in an hour.
Berserker.
20 minutes.
Berserker axe weapon. This axe was made to kill. It just needs your help to fulfill its destiny. Well, I am all about filling other people's destiny.
Axe was made for killing. Yeah.
Right. You roll 2 additional dice, maximum of 8 dice, when making a might attack with this weapon. If you are on a tile with one or more opponents, you cannot leave that tile unless you first attack an opponent with this weapon.
Okay.
It's great, but you gotta use it.
You have to use it.
You can't use another weapon while you're using this one. This omen can't be dropped or traded, but it can be stolen.
So it's like cursed, basically.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
All right, so you have a cursed axe. So anytime, there's no monsters on the board yet, but if like a haunt happens and there a bunch of zombies come out, you have to attack them because you have the amazing axe. Just
so you get to make an omen roll now.
That, you know,
unless you can convince one of your friends to steal it from you.
No.
6 is possible.
Nope. But not that way. Yeah. All right, so we are back to Ronnie. And you have your speed.
So Kevin, you were lucky.
You were in the warehouse.
High number.
So where can I go from here?
You could reveal another building. You could reveal another street. You could come back in. You could go to the catacombs.
Building, please.
The city is yours.
You're not going to follow me?
What?
Why?
Apparently not.
Exactly.
Smithy! Oh, and you get an event card at the smithy? I thought it would be an item card.
Okay. That's an event, huh?
Yeah, it's an event.
Okay.
At the smithy, what happens?
Rot. Grub. As I said, yeah. Something lands on your back and crawls into your hair.
Ew.
It might just be a common bug, but a rot grub could burrow into your brain in seconds.
Wow.
You must attempt either a speed roll. I think I'll do that.
Yeah.
To shake off the grub, or a sanity roll. No, thank you. to stay still and hope it leaves.
So what's the target on the speed roll?
5 or better.
Okay. So
you overcome the panic, gain 1 in the trait you rolled for.
Oh, you go to
speed.
You would become
Dummy.
The speediest character in the world.
I have 5 already.
So you roll 5 dice.
Are you thinking that you want to do sanity instead to make your sanity go up?
I was just asking.
Okay. Glad we established that.
Right. I do what I want.
Okay, yep. There we go. We're
okay.
It's over.
So, and you go
5
up,
plus that, right?
Yes. And
okay.
Yes, and you go up 1, so you now have a 6 speed, amazingly enough.
Yeah. Oh, whatever you roll, you add plus the number?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Well, she did it because she beat the rock grub, and that was the...
No, you don't add your score. You add
what?
Total the dice.
Oh.
You rolled 5. Yes.
But she did it.
Yeah, you did it.
So she goes up
anyway.
To 1 more speed.
Yep, yep.
Okay, I was under the impression I added this, so
no,
yay!
That's how many dice you rolled.
No, you made it even. I thought you knew, but you did.
Nope.
You did. Okay, now anything. You are done with
the card.
The card.
I don't get anything from that?
We got a point of speed.
Oh, great.
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
Pshaw. Who needs that?
So I guess you're done, unless you're not going to attack anyone or anything. Okay. Kevin?
Alrighty.
I mean, Daladus the Scarlet?
Daudius.
Daudius the Scarlet.
Alright.
Where's he gonna go? He's in a dead end. Back to the tavern, I'm guessing.
Apparently, one. Actually got
2.
Us.
Are you allowed to go that way?
3.
Why
yeah.
not?
Yeah, it's open.
There's a
street.
Oh, okay. You're really trying to leave the building, aren't you?
I did leave the building, but it was a dead end.
I guess this would be the most advantageous.
It's okay if it's a. This is called a false feature, like a boarded up door or something like that.
Wait, not no, that's not, there's no door there.
Oh no. Okay, so it has to be that way. You are correct.
I found the watch post.
Watch post, and something happens. A funny thing happened on the way to the watch post.
Balls call.
What?
Balls call.
Balls call?
Yep, that's what it says.
Okay.
You have a vision of a grotesque skull as blood pools around your feet and your ears echo with the pitiable cry of a tortured soul. I must attempt a sanity roll.
And,
what's your sanity?
I have a 4, so you roll 4 dice.
What are you rolling against, though?
It's 4 better to succeed.
Oh, okay. Oh, so it says on the card.
Yeah, it gives you on the card what your target is.
My mind is attacked. If your mind is attacked, the player on your right rolls a sanity 3 against you. You don't roll defense. Instead, if the result is higher than your sanity, you take mental damage equal to the difference between the two.
All right. Mental damage, let's see if he gets it.
No, he does not.
Okay, had he got it, mental damage can be divided up between knowledge and sanity. But he didn't get it, so Chris was being nice, and nothing happens. All right.
So
somebody ran through my room?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, it's not your room, it's the city of Baldur's Gate.
I'm going to follow him since I was following the other person. Okay. Follow me, and I'll continue this way.
And that is a building car.
Yes, that is correct.
Storehouse with 4 doors.
Wow. Should we move the catacombs down?
And an item.
Maybe. Woohoo, an item. I love items.
I'm going to come down.
I find a shiny... Oh, a shiny rock! Oh, boy! What a nice, beautiful rock. Surely someone will trade you for it. During your turn, if you are on the same tile as another adventurer, you may discard this item to steal an item that they control of your choice.
Oh, boy.
You can use this item on your turn to steal it.
Cool.
They cannot decline.
So what you can,
I think I can.
So what you do is, if you want, when you move into somebody else's tile, you can drop the rock and take their thing.
No, that is stealing it.
Oh, that's stealing it.
So he can steal it from you. Oh, okay. He can steal your axe. Maybe you want him to.
Huh?
All right, Mike, your turn.
All right, because you're not anywhere near me.
By the way, Mike, kudos to you. You're the brave soul who's the only one who's in the catacombs.
I've got my bomb.
That's true.
All right. Well, let's keep adventuring.
What you want, a blue one?
Yep.
Blue door.
There you go. What's it say?
As long as it's not a green door.
Smuggler's Drop.
Okay.
And I could be treasure.
Just put that in the best possible way. Sure.
It's a dead item. It's treasure.
Oh, is it a dead end?
That is a dead end.
Oh, okay.
Ring of X-ray Vision.
What?
Oh, nice. All right. Someone used strange magic to mount a living eye on this ring.
Ew.
Someone who undoubtedly placed utility far ahead of appearance. When you discover,
I know who that was.
When you discover a new tile, you may use the ring to look at the top 2 tiles of the stack and choose one to draw. Place the other on the bottom of the stack.
There we go.
After you use the ring, roll a die. If the result is 0, discard this item. As the ring slips out of your finger and rolls away.
Wow. Okay.
So that's really nice. That's a good item. No other rolls.
It doesn't
fall on the floor.
I assume you're keeping it?
Yes.
Okay. Good enough.
That's good.
Ballad is your turn.
Yeah.
Execution is blocked.
Come on, join the rest of us.
I am. I'm going to.
It looks like everyone's going south. Oh,
Ooh.
Oh, my God. Nothing happened.
Oh, did you have 3 movement?
That was it. Four.
You can
go 1 more, right?
No. 1, 2, 3.
4.
Oh, 4.
Yep.
I can.
Back to you.
Okay. So I'm not allowed to go directly over there. Right?
Correct.
I can
go
up. I can go that way.
Who's up?
Me.
Okay. And with your amazing 6 speed?
Yep.
You can go go anywhere on the board.
No, go to the dungeon. Come on and follow us.
Yeah, 1,
you're not
2,
going to
3,
the dungeon.
4.
What are you talking about?
I said follow us or go to the dungeon.
Okay, yeah.
It is nice. You kind of have 2 groups.
That's why I was like,
I can't let Mike go.
Last people stole from me.
Oh, that's how all the fun stuff happens.
He's not doing bad.
I can't go that way.
It's all fun.
No, that's a fireplace.
This way. Yeah. 1.
Okay.
2.
Yes.
3. Hi.
Hello.
4.
Yep.
4.
Hi. With the shiny rock.
What else is here? No, thank you.
Right, left, forward.
they're all outside or what?
Yep.
They're all okay. It's three buildings.
Empty buildings.
Sure, whatever.
Which way would you like to go?
Let's go that way. We haven't done anything over there. Yes. Thank you.
It is the mansion.
Oh.
The mansion.
Ooh, I hear this is the mansion of madness.
Dimension.
Do you want the building entrance free or do you want to the street or the two building entrances?
How do you decide?
You can do anything you want. You say try to build it like so that you have the most buildable spaces.
Yeah.
The most buildings.
It says you can't place a tile that would seal off a level. That's all.
Believe me when I say I am pronouncing this correctly.
Oh, and this is an event card.
This is the Yug tentacle.
Oh, yeah. That's those little garbage eaters. Yeah.
That's a garbage monster.
So the garbage eater is in the mansion.
Do you need a lozenge?
Exactly. Yug.
What does the garbage eater make you do in the mansion?
A grasping tentacle reaches out at you from a crack in the wall.
Okay.
From in the beyond the crack. I don't want to know about what comes beyond the crack.
No, don't
we
even.
We do need this square.
You can hear a low, hungry growl. There's a growler back there.
Okay. That's over the kitchen.
Okay, so he's an actual monster?
Yes.
Place the square.
Okay.
Ok-Yug.
He's on the square. There's now an Ok-Yug in the mansion.
Face him. Ok-Yug.
Does he attack you? Or?
On this tile and this card near it. After the haunt has begun, whenever a hero attempts to leave this tile, the Ok-Yug attacks.
Oh,
wow.
Here on the hero's right, that's you,
mm-hmm.
makes a might 3 attack against them. But I can just move through because opponents don't slow me in my movement. That's my cunning action.
Yeah, but you, your movement stopped because you drew a card.
But I had to.
I'm sorry. Kevin?
But no, this is only when she tries to leave.
Yeah.
Is it when she tries to leave, or
it's when she tries to leave?
That's after the haunt has begun.
Oh no, the haunt hasn't begun yet. So everyone knows the Ok-Yug's there, but he's asleep until the haunt begins.
So I can go into the room.
Yeah, he's not.
No, because you drew a card.
You drew a card, so your turn is over.
But, all right, the card's supposed to go near him.
Yeah. So everybody knows the Ok-Yug.
Well, there's no door there, so we're good.
See, I told you that's how you say it.
Yeah.
I believe you.
Yeah.
I still
However, I would say, though, I think if Val goes into the space with the Ok-Yug, even though it's passive, she would have to attack it because of the axe.
I hear you.
Well, there's not a way to kill it yet.
No. Oh, it doesn't have a score?
No.
Oh, it's not a monster. It's like a hazard.
Yeah.
He's in the wall. So, okay.
He just reaches out.
Tentacle reaching from a crack.
Right. He just wants a little lick.
What a terrible mansion.
All right, you ready?
Yes.
Boom, boom. Building.
There you go. Good luck.
I feel like you guys, we have way more catacomb.
Sorcerer's Sundries.
Ooh. Oh.
I get another event card.
Event in Sorcerer's Sundries. Good luck.
Yellow mold. Oh, yay. That's always fun.
Oh, that's the good stuff.
Plumps of sickly yellow mold grow here. Spores erupt from the mold and a coughing fit overcomes you. I need the square yellow mold token on this tile and this card near it. Anytime an adventurer enters this tile, including when you draw this card, that adventurer must attempt a might roll.
Because they might have to cough too.
So that card goes. Oh, you have to do it too, right?
Yep. I need a 4.
On the side.
Yes, I'm not very mighty.
But you look good in red.
Thank you. Nope, not enough.
Close.
So what happens? 10-foot pole to get out.
So close.
Yes. Oh, wait.
Yeah, you can do that, can't you?
Could you?
Oh, there we go. I'll reduce it to 0.
You touch the yellow mold with your pole.
All right, so you're discarding the 10-foot pole. Is it dropped or is it discarded?
It is discarded.
Okay, so it's discarded.
Yug.
So you're shoving yourself out of room, right?
What does the 10-foot pole actually do? Does it shove you or it?
I'm going to reduce the damage to 0.
Okay.
I would take 1 might damage normally.
Okay.
And so I'll discard this. I take 0. The yellow mold is still here.
Yes, so anybody that goes into that room is going to have to...
deal with the yellow mold.
And I just have to say, it seems like the catacombs are safer than the street.
Who would have thought that?
And have better stuff.
All right, Chris, you're up.
What are my options here? Can I go this way?
Yeah, you can go into the mansion with the Ok-Yug or the yellow mold. I wouldn't go north.
I can't go this way?
Yeah, you can.
Yes, you may.
That's a building tile.
North presupposes that one of us knows what direction is.
Yeah. Spies roost.
Right?
And it's a dead end.
Wow.
Is there anything in there?
Let's go to the basement,
yes.
guys.
Yes, that's an event. Yeah.
An event just for you.
Mm-hmm. Will-o-wisp.
Oh, man.
A flickering light appears in the gloom ahead. It bobs and weaves in the air, and you feel an overwhelming compulsion to follow it. It's a dead end. You must attempt a knowledge roll. 4+, you resist the urge, gain 1 knowledge. 2-3, remove your adventuring figure from the board at the start of your next turn. Place the figure on an revealed omen tile or the Elsong Tavern tile if there are no omens. Take 1 die of damage of physical. Take 1 die of physical damage. 0-1. All right, so I roll knowledge.
What's your knowledge?
Which one's the knowledge? 3.
So you roll 3 dice, and what's your target?
Well, I want a 4 or better.
Mm-hmm. Good luck.
Woohoo! Oh, almost.
3. Now, do you have any items that can help? No. No, those are for attack.
Shiny rock and a...
Yeah, no, they won't help. Okay.
So you got a 3.
So what happens?
Remove your adventuring tile. Remove your adventure from the board.
Okay.
At the start of your next turn, place your figure at any revealed omen tile or
which
the Elsling Tavern.
Which you want to
if there are no omens. Take 1 die of
physical. Oh, right there.
You could just jump right here.
Well, in his next turn. He can decide on his next turn.
You could just go down to the castle.
But he is going to take 1 physical die, 1 physical damage. So you may either take 1 point off of your might or your speed. It's your choice. It's physical damage. And we move over to Mike.
All right. And I hope a cleric somewhere can help me.
Yeah, there could be a cleric nearby.
I guess you probably have to find one then, huh?
All right, this appears
I think there might be one in the catacombs.
This is a dead end, right? So I'm going to come out of here.
Why is it a
dead
end?
I don't see any doors.
It's dead ends.
There's a door over there.
Oh, there's a door.
Yeah, this looks good.
Should I keep this till later?
Yep. Good luck.
Well, I took the damage, though.
Yeah, I can take it back.
They just gotta show up on the omen or
shrine to ball. Didn't we already get a shrine to ball?
No, I don't think so.
Oh no, that's right. There's another one.
Can you place it in a way that
ball something?
No, we got a shrine to Agrabah.
But no, I had a ball something.
Weren't you here, Gargarath?
Yeah,
I moved.
Yeah, he moved. Oh, you went back in.
What happens there? Anything? Oh,
omen.
There you go.
Oh, but we're gonna maximize doors, right?
Yeah, try to.
But you can't block that door.
Yeah, you can.
Yeah, you can.
You can actually.
Yeah. Does anything else happen there? It's just, does it sometimes...
End your turn here.
Oh, if you enter home, take 1 point of mental damage. So I want to keep moving, but I can't.
But you can't because you have to draw the card, yeah.
So you get 1 point of mental damage. That's sanity or knowledge, your choice.
Hmm.
Do not take a point of
I have really, they're all horrible.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
No,
I don't need sanity.
Not for carrying around the bottle of demons.
I feel like maybe you do, though.
In the shrine of ball is a homunculus.
Ooh. Oh, that's a familiar. He'll follow you.
Companion.
Yeah.
All right. A pitiable, misshapen humanoid figure formed from clay no more than a foot tall emerges from the shadows and stares at you with black, unblinking eyes.
Mama.
Gain one might and 1 knowledge. Lose 1 might and 1 knowledge if you lose control of the homunculus. This omen can't be dropped, traded, or stolen. Make a hot roll now.
So, okay, so go ahead and...
So I can't steal it?
Damn. No, go ahead and give me... So you get your sanity back. You could.
But when, he got knowledge.
Oh, it specifically says...
Might or knowledge. Okay. Basically, so if you take that out of knowledge instead of sanity.
He's smarter now.
And I can bump my knowledge with it?
No,
no,
just one or the other.
No, it's one or the other.
One or the other.
It says might and knowledge.
Yeah, but you took the point of sanity, though, didn't you?
Yes.
Yeah.
So that's kind of a good trade, point of sanity for unlimited power.
Yeah. It's so, basically a +1/+1, but when you get rid of the cards, you have to remove it back.
So now you need to make a haunt roll, and how many omens are on the board?
A lot.
4.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, so you need to roll 4 dice, and it has to be 6 or less.
Roll lots of blank hits.
That'd be good.
Nope.
Oh my god! The haunt just triggered.
Wow. You never listen to me.
Wow. Okay, so hold on. We have a haunt.
The tentacle's alive.
We need an alarm.
The tentacle's active.
I'm still in the room. Thanks.
Probably.
Hey, I'm going to the tavern.
I still have that vial of poison. I can always drink it.
I think that you can't. It doesn't say you have to go to one of the omen things.
Or the tavern.
If there's no omens.
So...
What happens if there's an omen?
Reading.
He has to go there.
I don't know. I turned the card back.
So you are the haunt revealer.
Get the will-o-wisp card out for a second.
Is this where we choose who becomes evil or something?
Well, we might or there might not be an evil.
It just depends. Okay, we got a haunt. I just got to find the chart.
Yeah, it's four.
Where's the haunt
if
chart?
If there are no.
So you have to go to the unknown location.
I have to go to unknown. There's four, though. There's like five out now.
Yes, there are.
I choose to want to go to
the same. Here's the haunt chart.
I like to go to one.
So, Mike, what you do is you're going to be picking the haunt.
God.
Look at the tile you're on and the card that triggered the haunt and put those together and you'll get a number.
All right, so I'm looking for a shrine of all.
What
am I looking for? Homunculus?
The homunculus triggered the haunt, right?
Yep. Yes. 25.
Okay, so that is the number that is going to be the haunt. So then you look at page 25.
Okay. On here or your book?
What book is that? That's the treasure book, right?
Yep.
Okay, hang on. Let's see.
Wait, he's a traitor because he's
no, no, not necessarily.
You just get to read about
maybe.
Him.
Maybe.
Page 25. It says haunt here.
Yeah, the traitor's tome.
Do I read this?
Wait a minute. Hold on. Let me read. The chart, Lewis. Okay, we got that. The haunt's entry below the chart states which player becomes the traitor. The haunt's entry below the chart.
Well, I don't want him to read this. You should be looking at
it. Yeah, let me look at it since we have a DM.
Otherwise, we're going to.
Because if it's not you, then you'll know who the traitor is.
Yeah. Oh. Now running.
It was 25, right?
No, I can't read that small. Are you kidding me?
We just told him to the card.
I only
here.
Pretend I can when students try writing that small. I'm like, stop that.
It's 25.
I know exactly what you're writing.
I was trying to read a recipe for Florentines today, and I'm like, this print is too small.
They keep making it smaller and smaller. What is wrong with that?
No,
no Florentines.
Your vision has changed.
What? No.
Old.
You're
old.
I'm a spring chicken.
Old.
We're going to edit this part out.
Okay.
I just realized I brocked on.
Well, I assume she will because John's reading
the
whole
part. Well.
Where's Allison? Where's Allison anyway?
I don't know.
In the kitchen?
I think she took the kid
that
wanted
the kid. That,
so there's some
I
kid.
Know, I don't even know what time it is because my phone vanished when we ordered pizza.
Ordered out. I think she went upstairs with him reading the book.
She
was on the couch reading books.
Actually, you push stop for a second.
Are we back? It's not very far from the kitchen.
That's as far as you can get. It'd be in the kitchen.
Now that you are.
Oh, it has to be.
No,
in the
but since it's haunting, if we have the a light moving, it's more atmospheric.
Yes. Okay. So now, video's back on. We're placing an iron golem and a mad wizard on the catacomb tile that's farthest away from the kitchen.
I thought you got the iron golem.
He did.
Okay. So. And I'm also going to place a number of small monster tokens to represent the number of heroes. Number of heroes plus two. These represent mad cultists. Where do they go? On a catacomb tile that doesn't contain another. If there are not enough catacombs, spread their remaining. Okay. So there are what, five heroes, right? So
yes.
There's going to be
seven. Mad cultists.
Yeah, so put seven mad cultists.
Which ones are mad cultists?
Whichever one he wants, as long as they're the same.
Are they mad or are they just angry?
Okay.
They're a little angry.
They're going to go... Basically, you have to put one on each tile in the catacombs, and then you can put the other two wherever you want, but they have to be on the in the catacombs.
Yeah.
Catacombs got real dangerous real fast.
Yeah.
And not in the kitchen?
With the characters and no characters.
Oh,
it can be on
the
characters.
So
yeah.
Safe.
Yeah.
With the...
Ukla. Well, he uses a tentacle.
No, see, that's Ukla aerial ride.
Tentacle and a crack.
Why does it go there?
Because he picked it at random.
I could put him with you guys if you want. There's already three guys in there.
No, all right. No, just, fine.
I was going to serve an even distribution.
Oh, but we can all go down there and then we can all die. So.
Yeah.
We're fine, right? Okay.
And you can drive home. Then you're good.
I can pop in down there. I don't really want to.
Well, that is your choice.
You should do what you think is best, of course.
What is this again? The I'm tired of your... Okay, yeah.
Yes.
I'm ready.
How do we find...
Okay, here's what happens. Okay.
So, the cultists are monsters. They're going to be attacking you. The Iron Golem is a really powerful monster that's going to be attacking you. Right. I'll play the monsters on my turn, but I go last after all of you guys.
Right.
Now, what you need to do is, what you know, here's what you know.
Oh, I love your
damage. So, can we find out if there's a traitor?
There's no traitor in this one. It's just a really hard scenario.
Ooh.
Yeah. Doomed.
Yay!
I don't have my 10-foot pole anymore.
After the haunt, play begins with the player to the traitor's left. So who begins the...
There's no traitor.
Mm-hmm. Yep. I understand, but it says after the haunt. Yep. Play begins the traitor's left.
Mm. Cultist of the mad god Sirik. Have driven one of the wizards of Baldur's Gate insane. Now her iron golem is running amok while the cultists use the chaos as cover for a dark ritual that only the wizard can stop. If we cure the wizard's madness, we can stop the golem and the ritual. You say to your companions, we must get her to Sorceress Sundries. Which isn't revealed yet.
It's right here.
Oh, is it? Yeah, okay. Oh, you're lucky.
With the yellow mold.
Okay, so what you have to do is, one of you has to get onto the tile with the wizard. You have to do a sanity plus 4 check to convince the wizard to follow you. And then you have to run him back up to Sorceress Sundries where he
gets... What is the sanity plus 4? It means we get, like...
You need a four.
Your sanity is your number of dice you roll. So like you need to do 3
not
plus
not
1.
Not it.
Anyone with sanity.
Meanwhile, the other people can fight and try to. The golem basically can't be killed, but you can hit him.
What's the point?
Yeah, that's true.
What's the name of the wizard again?
He's just a mad wizard of Baldur's Gate.
Alrighty then.
But it's definitely a he.
Yes.
Could be a they.
Just saying.
Well, I don't know.
So there's no way to kill the Iron Golem that we know of.
Would be a witch of Baldur's Gate, see?
It's an Iron Golem. We don't
just
have
saying.
Any, we don't have any powerful magic items to kill an Iron Golem.
We have that big missile, and that's it.
I have an axe.
I have a poison.
Poison is not going to affect an Iron Golem. Come on, we know that.
I'm just ready to go kill stuff. Let's
do it! The Iron Golem has a might of 6 and a speed of 3. Each cultist has speeds of 3. Knowledge of 2 and sanity of 4. The cultist move and attack before the Iron Golem during the monster turn, which occurs after the haunt reveals turn. Each cultist moves toward the closest hero's tile and attacks them, if possible, using sanity. The defender rolls only sanity, taking mental damage on
the person that has already wounded sanity is going to be attacked.
Yeah, now you can die too, so be careful.
All right.
Okay, so Val, you are first.
All right.
Why am I first?
Because
you're next.
You're the next person in the line.
All right.
We don't have a traitor.
Oh,
so.
That's right. You homunculus.
You may want to go.
You homunculus. Oh no, I'm not leaving anywhere. I've got an axe. All
right.
And I'm gonna whoop some ass.
Oh, that's right.
I can't go anywhere with this axe.
That's
right.
No one can question your axe.
So what does it say? Does it say when it's in your tile? Because it spawned on your tile, so I would say you could ignore that, but it's the next one you move
into. Well, no, it's supposed to... For memory, it says you actually have to deal with whatever's in your...
Oh,
if you are on the tile with one or more opponents, you cannot leave that tile unless you first attack the opponent with this weapon.
Oh, there you go, then.
So,
attacky.
So I guess that's your first action.
That's right. So my might is a 3, and the axe gives me 2 more, so give me 5 dice. I can count that high.
Cultists have a might of 3...
So I have to roll what?
More than 3.
Please.
No problem.
Okay, so
and yes.
That cultist is dead.
Sweet. Dead.
Wow. You collect it like a trophy?
No, you don't.
That's the Cthulhu sound or something.
You can do any other actions you want. You can move.
Can I move and kill some more?
One attack per turn after the hunt begins.
Foff!
Go through a door. Let's start some more.
Although for her, I don't know, because... She has to attack.
No, it says after the hunt, you get 1 attack per turn.
Let me read the. There's a special rule
for
the
axe. But it says you cannot leave the tile unless you first attack.
Hold on, let me. There's actually a rule for the axe. I saw it.
Ooh.
I mean.
You can always start a new room.
If a haunt or card rule would keep you from attacking the opponents on your tile, you may move freely.
That's all it says.
Yep, otherwise you have to attack.
I think you have to kill an adventurer until they're gone. And then now next time you'll be able to move in that room because there's nothing.
But you can still move.
Well, that's what I'm saying. If I just want to, I'm just going to keep.
So she can move without attacking then.
Right. Okay. She can move, but doesn't. Yes. But you've already attacked. You don't attack again. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I don't know what your sanity is, but would you like to try to go to the wizard's tile and get him to follow you? I mean, that's how you ultimately win, to get the wizard
can
up to.
Can you move through monsters without them attacking you?
No.
I can't. I can go into a room with the.
No, weapons, you have a choice. I think.
But I
can't
leave it without attacking.
You can move closer, or you move to a new room.
Does that make them? When the cultists move, they're going to go to the nearest.
Right. But if you move to another room, that'd be him.
No, I'll come to me.
Depends on which room I move to.
If you go here, he.
Other adventurers might come down to help you too,
yes,
but I don't know how far they are.
If I move here, then they could. This one will come to me.
No, I'll come
today, and those two will go to you.
Yep.
So if I don't go any.
If you stay put,
here,
what happens?
It's 50-50.
Well, this one's definitely not going anywhere, so I'm going to move here.
Okay.
So I'll deal with three, and you deal with three, and Chris might come down and help one of the two of us.
That's true. If somebody can get down there, they can help you out.
Now, since this wall's blocked, does that assume it's still a walk? We both can go both ways, or is it a one-way door?
No, it's not a one-way door. It's a false door.
So they can't go through.
So they can't go through there.
That's correct.
Oh, so, yeah.
They're gonna
fight. I got this.
Yeah, they actually can't get to anybody.
Except they're gonna attack, when they attack you, you defend with sanity.
And?
Not
that's
the
apparently
axe.
Good for her.
Okay.
Oh, you're okay with that? Okay.
All right, there we go.
It's my mind and my sanity are exactly the same.
All right, Ronnie, what do you want to do? Now we know where the evil is. It's in the catacombs. Who knew? It's a little tiny. It's like a sewer grate, practically.
Which way do I have to go in order to get there?
To get
to the kitchen.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 to the kitchen. 7.
Okay, that's good.
Well, the thing is to leave the Odiak room, though.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah,
suddenly...
but you know what? No, opponents don't slow my movement. Sorry. Try again.
Is that actually an opponent?
Well, he's not trying to.
It is now.
Well,
he attacks you when you leave the room.
Well, he doesn't slow you, but I still think he gets a swipe at you, right?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, actually, when you this is not an opponent. This is basically an encounter.
An event, right?
Yes. An event.
I don't know.
Well, she's rolling against her speed anyway. It's not like she's not going to do it, right? What is it, a speed check?
No. I have to make a might 3 attack against them.
Okay.
Wait, but if you're attacking, how are you not an opponent?
Whatever. It's an arm going to a little hole.
It doesn't make any sense, that's all.
It says it's an event. Isn't actually a monster.
It's just like tentacles.
Yeah, but that's like saying an omen card is an omen, even though it's a thinning, like a berserker axe. But okay. We'll go with what you say.
Because all you're getting is the tentacle.
No, because you're the head white dude, so do it. Just go.
Wait, Mike, you can take that from your opponent. Yeah.
It's a video, Pete. I can't help.
Yes, yes.
I'm not saying anything.
You're a GM. What do you say?
I would say that she, you know what? Well, because she was in the room when the haunt began, I will say that she can go ahead and leave the room. But anyone else that goes through there would have to. So go ahead. You want to go to the kitchen?
Yeah, I don't care.
What's your speed?
6.
Okay, so she gets to the
yep.
kitchen.
Yep.
All right, Kevin.
I'll go 1, 2, 3, 4.
All right, Chris.
Where are the omens?
They're the ravens. There's one here where he is, here where I am.
One over here.
Here, one over here.
Oh, you could jump. You could drop into the.
He instantly poofs over to.
Yes,
the
you could drop into the catacombs and attack the cultists.
To it, man. You are in the omens.
You could drop
zone.
Into the space where Val's character is and kill one of the cultists.
Or you could do the same thing in
Mike's space.
But Mike's space is actually.
Mike is going to be safe. No, Mike's safe, remember?
There's a cultist there.
Cultist in his
Or you could go there and kill that cultist. Yeah, that's
who has a good sanity?
Not me.
Not Mike. You probably want to save him. Yeah.
I drop in here.
Okay.
What the heck? I'll attack this.
Use your hunter's mark.
I will mark this cultist.
Yep. Okay.
And I will attack them.
Yes.
That gives me a +1 to attack, and I have a might of 3.
Okay.
So,
And you add plus one to your roll, right? So you automatically get one. You have to roll.
Is it plus one or plus one die?
Is it plus one die or plus one? So, well, just say die or plus one. One to the result. You get an automatic plus one. Mm-hmm. So whatever you roll, you have to get a three.
Four or five.
Wow, you didn't even need the plus
and
one.
What items do you have, Mike?
My homunculus and an iron flask of a demon, basically a demon flask.
And a ring of X-ray vision.
Oh, and a ring of X-ray vision, right? I have three different things.
I'm going to drop the shiny rock and take the homunculus. Oh, the homunculus can't be stolen, though?
No, it cannot.
No, it cannot. Can't be dropped. Wait a minute.
Oh, and pull the cultist. Kill the cultist.
I can't be dropped from either stolen. How do you lose it?
You die.
Oh, but at that point, why would you ever bother about removing it anyway? It must be special.
Are you
it
might
be
a special card to deal.
No, I don't want the X-ray of X-ray vision.
Or you can take the iron flask.
The demon flask of death.
Demon flask, that's safe.
Guarantees that you'll die along with anything else in the room. Except for the wizard who's invincible.
That roll of might.
I'm good on that. Fine.
Okay. Mike, it's your turn, and then the monsters are going to go.
All right. Well, I don't really want to face these guys. They're kind of scary.
No, if you're attacking them, you can attack them using anything you want, even might. They just attack you with sanity.
Well, I'm a berserker, so maybe I'll come in here.
Okay. Right.
I'll try attacking them.
Okay. They have a might of three. I assume you're using might, using any special abilities, or you can use your flask and kill everybody in the room.
Let's be in a room with a golem.
Wait for me if you're gonna.
I have
a
six mind. I'll just use.
All right, make your roll. You need to
use that many dice roll.
Yeah.
And you have to get a three. I think he's gonna do it.
Barely.
Wow. Man, you have like D6 curse.
All right.
There you go.
You only do one attack, right? I can't kill both of them.
No, you only do one attack per turn. Is there anything else you want to do? Special abilities or anything?
Throw the flask in the other room.
Can you do that?
Nope. You can't move after I
attack.
Demon
grenade!
Right?
You can move after you attack, but you can't attack again.
Ooh, I'm going to move. I'm going to run away.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That's smart.
Move into the
bravely run away.
Oh, yeah, you can reveal another tile. Sure, if you want to.
I would like to see two tiles with my extra vision.
So you can see two and pick the one you want.
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
you
go.
Yes,
you
can.
All right.
Oh, no, he's a traitor.
Yeah, vacated shop or weapon shop basement. Ooh, weapon shop basement sounds good.
And that goes to the bottom.
Okay, what does weapon shop basement say?
Oh,
it's an item. Okay.
You can exit from here to the weapon shop by spending one additional space of movement.
Is the weapon shop out yet?
It is not.
It is not.
Not yet.
But
And
you get an item. Move your guy into that tile, too.
All right, Ring of the Ram. I have all these rings.
Oh, that's a nice one.
Is it?
This iron ring is decorated with a pair of ram's heads. You roll one additional dice when making a might attack with this weapon.
You get another
die. If you damage an opponent with this attack, you may immediately move that opponent to an adjacent connected tile. You
push him back.
That could be useful for the column.
Yep.
You can't use another weapon while you're using this one. Mm-hmm. And I don't know how many weapons.
See, now, I thought it would help with you with your dodge.
Oh,
it's a card joke.
Oh, dodge,
right?
Where am I?
Nice. It's a
card
joke, right?
You're here all week.
Valerie's here all week. All right, Val, your turn. Oh, no, monster turn. Sorry, monster turn. Monster turn. Give me some
monsters, just skip the turn if you want.
All right, so...
Ooh, you okay?
Do they move or... Don't
the,
Yes, they do.
Obviously, can you move the two cultists that are by themselves over one?
Not through the
floor. Only one?
No, they have a speed of three.
Oh, that's right.
That's right. Me here by my lonesome!
And the iron golem, does he move?
Not yet. No, he's going to go separate. Yeah.
Four cultists.
All right, are you ready?
Yep.
And you're rolling. They're attacking with sanity. For some reason.
They're trying to drive you crazy. Must be middle schoolers.
That's what they do with the mage, so that's what they want to do with...
That's fine.
All right, what's your sanity?
They have to beat her score? or do they
that can roll? Beat her score. I don't think it's an opposed roll.
And so okay. You get four times, you'll be rolling that?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh my god.
Two. Nope.
Miss.
Fail once. One. Fail twice.
These are not very sane cultists. There's one.
Five.
Okay, so lose one sanity. Actually, it's lose one mental. You can lose sanity or intelligence.
Oh, you have tons of knowledge.
Oh, geez, I'll just lose a knowledge.
Okay.
I agree. Because my knowledge is at five.
And
another
one.
Miss. Damn, four misses.
Not bad.
All right, no, Iron Golem time.
It was three misses and a hit.
Yeah.
Iron Golem. No, he does the same thing. Iron Golem doesn't have the smart idea. Move the Iron Golem forward.
Boom, boom, boom.
Oh, my God.
It is a big one.
Does crazy wizard follow him?
No. Yes, oh, yes, he goes with him.
Oh, there we go.
Does the crazy wizard also attack?
He does not. He's just, and you just try to...
Good, because I don't think I like him in that bathroom.
You need to peel him away from the golem and get him up to the sundries.
Why can't the golem come with him?
Why couldn't the golem come with him?
Yeah, we just get them all both in the room.
I mean, why can they both go?
I guess. So you want to run all the heroes up into the sundries and then have the golem follow you in? I guess you could.
Is he gonna? Does he attack every time?
The golem goes towards the closest character and attacks.
Okay.
So you could run everybody into the sundries place.
And we'll just hang out in the old mole.
And wait for him to show up. I suppose that could work. Somehow.
I expect the yellow mole doesn't bother him.
Oh my gosh.
Two, six? Three, four, five, six, seven. I assume you...
Your mind's less than seven?
Wait, is that seven? No, that's...
Yes, yes it is.
Seven. I assume... Now, is your might with the axe less than seven?
Yeah. It's only for making attacks.
Oh, okay.
It's not a...
Okay, so you lose a physical. You either lose a speed or a might.
I'm gonna lose a might because my if I go down one might, it's the same. My might goes 3-3 dead.
Mm-hmm.
You might want to think about moving.
She can't with the axe.
Oh, I'm sorry. To convince the wizard to go with you, it's a knowledge roll.
That changes everything!
Well, it's your turn next.
The good news is right
yes,
here.
Yes, but I just lowered my knowledge because
yeah.
I was like,
well,
I'm using
knowing
knowledge
that,
anything.
If you'd like to lower something else,
but here's
I'll
the
let
problem.
Yes.
She has the axe, so she can't lead to all the monsters she did.
Yeah.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
Okay. Well.
So someone else is going to have to.
So how?
No, what we do is we get the thief to run in and steal the axe, and then you run out of there with the wizard.
Yes, that sounds good.
How's that sound, thief?
I'm not a thief.
How's that sound, shiny rock bear?
He's not the thief, I'm the thief.
So,
yes, but he's got a shiny rock.
Now, that was you defending.
Hold on, tell me how.
Now you can do
it. Now it's, that was, now it's your turn.
Yeah, it's our turn to attack.
Yep.
You can attack one thing in the room.
I probably wouldn't do the golem.
The golem is basically invincible. You can't kill the golem.
Please, there's only might six.
Yeah, but he's, he can't be killed.
Oh.
No damage.
Well then, let's see.
That means whoever steals that stupid berserker axe is going to
why is he still drinking it?
What do you mean? Yes. I mean, because he's going to have to drive that out. Well.
Here's the deal, though. Whoever steals that's going to be stuck there with their own golem. We're stuck in a trap, right?
True.
Game mechanic trap.
You die for the cause.
Someone's going to have to die before that axe is.
Or you just cut through them all. But I don't know. It's up to you.
I can steal it, but then I'd have to stay and fight everything.
Well, only until the game ends, which is until they get the wizard back to the sundry spot. Can you survive a couple rounds?
No. No one's going to survive that.
So what does it take to convince the wizard to follow you?
A knowledge four.
So can I do that then attack?
Mm-hmm.
You could, yes. But, so the wizard's sanity would be cured.
And then someone else needs to steal your axe, and you need to take the wizard to this place.
But do I have to? Once the
you can attack one and then leave.
Oh, there you go. Do that. Perfect.
So do your sanity first.
Attack one,
and then leave.
And then
oh yeah, that could work. That could work.
So I do your knowledge first, see if you're even bother leaving.
Right.
And what? How is the golem going to work? Is it going to follow the wizard?
He'll try to. No, the golem will keep following characters.
The closest character. Yeah. She runs away. She won't be the closest character anymore.
Right.
That depends on if someone else comes in there. So I can.
Well, no. If you go two spaces away, they're not closest.
Running.
Okay, so I have to. I attack One, because I have to.
Yes.
I convince the wizard,
yes.
hopefully.
And then you run.
I run away with the wizard
yes.
for my movement, which is
yes.
4. Except for the wizard's movement is 3.
So you get 3.
You get 3.
Whatever.
But at least you'd be out of that hellhole.
I'd be in the inner chamber.
Yeah.
Yeah. yeah.
You're being right. safe.
And then everything's going to be following you up. But oh no, there's still guys down there. Yeah, 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 that's right. Yeah.
You don't think I'm going to run?
That's right. You peel them off. All right,
so let's go ahead and...
Do the attack, because we have to Z-attack.
No matter what, we do the attack. You okay?
Yeah.
She's filming the cat.
She's getting the priority stuff here.
All right, so...
5.
I assume you kill a cultist. Yes.
Yes.
Remove cultist.
Cultist dead.
Okay, now. Now
I'm going to use a healing... Well, see, because I want to put my knowledge back up to 5, so I can roll 5 dice, right?
Okay.
Yes?
Yeah.
I'm going to use my...
That's...
No, it says...
Special?
Once during my turn, I can discard a healing wound token.
Okay. It's legal.
To gain one that is below my starting value, which is...
Right. So your knowledge is back up.
My knowledge is back up to a 5, so now I can roll 5 dice.
And say, hey, wizard, what are you doing?
Hey!
Don't do this crazy stuff.
Oh. Fuck me!
I'm sorry.
I'm gonna use a clue token.
What?
I was gonna use a clue token, but I don't have any.
Okay, well, that didn't work. Would you still like to move? I don't know what you want to do. You have the best chance of convincing the wizard, maybe move away?
Oh, wow.
No, because if she moves away, she can't talk to the wizard.
She's got might as well to stay then.
That's nice.
Oh.
Well, because she's also got some of the best
chances. She's the one that has the highest knowledge, yeah.
I also have knowledge 5, but that's she's the only one there right now.
Okay. You want to do anything else? That was a really good plan, by the way.
Yeah.
It's only brilliant when you win. I can't get the wizard.
So what did you get?
He's still looking. What do I want to steal?
Wings of the ram. Plus I have 1 extra die. Yeah. And knocks him into the room.
Alright.
Yep, I'm gonna just... I didn't even know what the ends were. Hang out here with... Wait.
No, actually, I wasn't... You know, I was like, what did I do? I'm not gonna win.
If we... If I move over here, they're not going to move until...
After Mike.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
But you guys are going to come in here, probably. And that's 1, 2...
They're trying to get to you, I think.
Yeah, you'll get
there. I'm not.
What?
No, they're cultists. They scare me. I'm going to keep going, trying to get to that door.
Do you know how teamwork works?
No.
Yeah, Mike, you're not a traitor. Hey, you would move back in.
I'm going to come visit you with this lovely drink.
I'm serious.
Of course I'm going to help you.
If you're not going to come help me, you get to choose what you want to choose.
Yes, I will.
But it affects my planning.
Okay.
Can I choose
because
an axe for a while?
If you're not going to come help, I'm going to bring him to you.
All right. I'm going to go help. I'm going to detonate the demon. One way or another, we're going to clear that man.
Oh, you could, but then that means you need to get, that means you need to get out of the room.
Yeah, I would move that room, and then I'll move in there, and I'll blow
it up. I'm done.
The wizard is going to
die. No, move out one. Move out one, and I'll run in.
Can't the wizard...
If the wizard dies, then we lose.
Wizard can't die.
Wizard can't die. He's impervious like that.
Also things I needed to know.
I did say that.
You said the golem couldn't die.
The golem and the wizard are invincible for now.
Now we know. What'd you drink
this year? So you could move out. He could run in and nuke it. And then it would be clear, and then
you could nuke it more. That's the only way to be sure.
But he would die.
He would probably die, but you could win.
But we could win.
But he would you die?
I don't think so. I have 6 might and 6 dice for the roll.
Yeah, he might not die.
He might live.
There's definitely a small chance. I think it's a hell of a good plan, personally.
Yeah, why not? Sounds fun.
You just got to move
one
up.
Okay, but if I leave the room, which I can definitely do.
Yeah.
Then you're going to come to the room and then leave it again?
Yes, you can do that.
For me?
You can do that?
Yeah.
We can all do that.
I was going to run and steal this treasure.
Anyway.
Do you know what teamwork is?
I don't know if that ends my turn, though.
No, it does not. You can continue moving.
I get 5 move. I can go boop, 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 upstairs.
Well, this is the stairs.
This is a dead end. Or it's not a dead end, but that's going to the door.
Anyway.
I was going to go 1,
well, don't be
2,
there.
3, 4, 5.
Ouch.
Perfect.
Okay.
Ronnie, your turn.
Okay, sure.
I think we should all start, even if we're just leaving all of the bad guys
true,
with us, because they're all aggro.
The,
we need to
them
lead
up, yeah.
them to the sorcerer's.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that you could win that way, too, just by fighting.
Okay, what do you want me to do?
Why don't you get down and beat one of those guys
doesn't the wizard
up?
Need to be
sure,
willing
whatever.
To do that in the sorcerer's?
I can move four there.
His no. arrival doesn't do it. Doesn't he need to be willing to go there?
The Iron Golem's going to move.
Again, figure out what you want me to do and then
go
do
down
it.
There.
Go, yeah, put it down there then. Whatever.
One, two.
Kill something.
That's you. One, two.
I don't even know how.
Yeah.
Okay. Your
no,
might.
It's just one.
It's three.
Two.
It's three.
Yeah.
And you can use your poison vial if you want.
Kill
you,
one.
You need to roll three,
no.
four dice. No?
Four dice.
No poison?
Saving that for myself.
So roll three dice, and knowledge is zero.
Excellent.
Okay,
yeah.
Now,
but
you still have movement left. If I were you, I'd
try to convince the sorcerer to go with you.
She didn't
hear you. How do I do that?
You need to make an intelligence roll.
Knowledge roll four?
Yep, knowledge roll four.
What?
Oh, she's trying to convince the wizard.
She's trying,
yeah.
She might as well.
Yeah.
Nothing to lose. Oh, so
he is a stubborn
no.
wizard.
And so you're moving
oh,
out, right?
Be, yeah.
You're moving back one?
Right.
And you want to move back one.
And then
they're going to detonate
the
room.
No, no.
You
I want to be
one?
In the room. She wants to
my
be in the room where it happens.
I'll go one, two, three. I can attack from here.
Oh, you have range?
Oh, wizard.
Yes. Bing. Magic missile.
Magic
missile. Wait, say it the right way. Magic missile.
So I roll my knowledge.
Yep.
And I'll shoot one of the cultists. Hit a five,
easily.
Six, and kill one of the
cultists. Well, now it's not worth it for me to release the.
No,
game.
It's not.
Yeah.
Yes, it is.
What a
no.
surprise that it's not.
It's not. I can kill one.
It's not.
My
it's
turn?
Not.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. He needs
one.
A tissue because it's not.
Look at the shiny rock.
All right. Do you want extra vision? Or
no.
the ring of ram?
Ring
of
ram.
Thank you.
Did you sell the point rock?
Yeah.
Which one am I? It's not
me. That's not you. You're the tall
two,
truck.
Three. Attack the cultist.
Okay.
Go.
With the ring around.
Mark it.
Yep.
Mark one of them.
Okay.
Yep.
We know they're marked.
He's going through the motions.
I don't kill it. They stay marked until I die. All right. Ring of ram gives me a whatever. So I roll might. My might is a three.
Mm-hmm. Plus one for the ring of ram?
Yep, next one for the ring of ram.
And you add one to your dice
and
because he's marked.
One. Yes.
And you can throw him into the other room
if
you want.
If he doesn't die.
He's dead.
Okay, pull him off.
Your mark comes back.
Cool.
Dead cultist.
Did you see Thor
Ragnarok? So,
yes.
One, two, three, four.
Maybe hang out there.
Okay. Mike.
All right, I'm moving.
You're right. It's no point in using the bottle because you could kill the last living thing in the room.
I thought you said the wizard was invulnerable.
But the last cultist.
Less vulnerable creature in the room.
Besides himself.
Correct.
Just kill it.
They're doing pretty good. I'm going to go investigate this.
Do you understand what you are enabling him?
I just hand people cards.
It was like a weapons basement. So now I want to see what's coming out, and it's a rat's nest.
Okay.
Exciting.
Well,
all right.
When did you go up to the store?
If you end your turn here, take 1 point of physical damage. So I don't want to end my turn.
Well,
here.
You have to because you're going to draw a card.
You're right.
Oh
man.
But you could have, no, hold on. Why didn't you use the ring of X-ray vision to look at what was in there?
You're right. I should have. I don't know, I didn't think about it.
Sorry.
Alright.
Too late now.
Forgotten
relic. I only hand people cards.
It was worth it. Forgotten relic right here. Tucked away in the corner, scribed in the wall,
so
is the holy symbol of Tyr, god of justice.
I stole the wrong thing.
Perhaps this place can offer some aid. You must attempt a knowledge roll. That's gonna go well.
Sorry.
Alright, let's attempt a knowledge roll.
How many nice do you need?
I got three.
Two.
Yep, three. Right. No problem.
What's your target number?
Well, for the best thing, it would be 5+.
Okay.
It's doable.
Four is still good, and then the 0 to 3 is not good.
All right.
You sure you want to roll?
Yeah, it's a choice.
Not good means nothing happens.
One. So that one is in the not good range.
Here must not find you worthy. Nothing happens.
Oh.
You know why he doesn't find you worthy? Because you banned
you take one point of physical damage.
Oh, monster turn.
I take a point of damage because I can't leave the room.
Yeah. Please move the cultist and the zombie into the room with... Oh, and the wizard. Everybody.
There's no zombies.
Sorry, I don't know why I said zombie.
Cultist.
I'm just here to dance.
I'm sorry. I should have tried to influence the... I didn't, but I should have tried to influence the wizard. I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I'm just going to go one. Who's got character number 4? You? Okay, so... The cultist is attacking you.
Are you there?
Yes, I am.
The cultist that could be dead if we had a person on our team.
That's
who
true.
The team.
Yeah.
Totally would have been dead.
Does 3 beat your sanity?
No, it does not.
Okay, so nothing happens.
Iron Golem to attack me.
And now the golem.
No.
Character 3.
You didn't have to start a new thing.
Who's character number 3?
That might be me. I'm 3.
Okay, you're attacked with the golem.
Great hero die.
Might 6. I need one more die. What's your mic?
Why doesn't he get my mic?
Yes.
Is it 3?
Okay. I suck at
DJ. Yeah, I might get the Ring of the Ram back.
No, I don't. You take 1 point of physical damage. It can be either might or speed.
I'll go down 1 in speed because it doesn't affect much.
Well, it affects your movement.
Well, I actually went 6. I was going 5.
Okay. Well, that's all right.
I should run one further.
And that is the monsters, and now we're back to Val.
Yeah.
So she has to attack. Because
I can only attack because, yes. So my might is still 3, and I get 2.
And you're attacking the one thing that can die, which is the, yeah.
Oh, you tell cultists.
Gotta get a 3.
I did.
I got a 4. Alright, remove him. Cultists are at least not a factor anymore. Now, would you like to try to convince the stupid wizard
yes,
to go
please.
With you?
My knowledge is also okay.
No, I tried
another
one.
6.
7.
Dang.
7.
The wizard goes, what the heck am I doing here?
I don't know.
God.
Let's go.
What are all these dead cultists?
Dude, don't worry.
Somebody's got to clean this place up. I'm a wizard of Baldur's Gate. Where do you want to go? How about the sundry shop?
Follow me.
You feel like a cone?
1, 2.
He can only move 3, right?
Yeah, he can only move
3. 3, okay. Well then.
I'm tired. Let's stop in the tavern. Get a drink.
All right.
Ronnie's turn. She's not here. Do you want to take her turn for her?
She can't do anything to him, correct?
No, but she can run away.
She'll run
Does
away.
Does the golem come with him?
Well, no, the golem will attack on his name. The golem keeps doing what he's doing. The golem just randomly attacks the closest character.
In that case, she should go further. She can.
She's going to go a little bit past.
She can go investigate a room.
She could,
but she's not going to.
Because it's only going to cause trouble. Chris, your turn.
That's my turn.
Oh,
that's
sure, Kevin.
I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay. Chris?
I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is
this
5 here?
Yes.
Yes, it is.
So I'm the only person that stayed with the wizard.
Mike, your turn.
Could I have gone one more, or do I have
no.
to stay
You could have gone one more, but the wizard couldn't.
Right.
How many can the golem move, though?
The wizard would try to follow you, but he can only go 3. Yeah, right. I assume you'd stick with him just because you're escorting him.
You guys...
Well, I have a question.
Where are you going, Mike?
How many can the golem move?
3.
And if you moved 4 away, would Mike be closer to the golem than you were?
No.
Maybe. We'll see. 1, 2, 3. I haven't moved yet. I can move closer to the golem to get it to come towards me.
Do you want to move closer to the golem?
Maybe.
Because sometimes
the golem's physical. So
anyway, we're already gone. Let's go ahead and go, Mike.
Well, no, it makes a difference for what he's doing now. Because if he moves closer, then he protects us from the golem.
Yes, he does.
But you don't have to.
But you may be feeling bummed because the God of Justice said that you're...
You want to get out of that space. If you end up in that space, you will die.
Right.
Slowly.
All right.
Yeah, so you definitely want to leave. 1, 2.
Oh, you don't want to stay there. That's probably the...
This guy moves 3?
Yes.
Yep.
See, there's nowhere I can go that
long. What's
your move?
I can go into another room.
You can't go there. You can go this way.
Yes, yeah.
1, 2, 3. 4.
4.
You could play with the golem.
Why don't you just move 1 and make the golem go farther away?
I think no matter what I do, it's going to be...
Oh, you could go explore a new room.
You can't leave that room.
There's no door.
That's a dead end.
That's a dead end, too?
Yep.
Is this a dead end?
Yep.
The only option is here. That's it.
Everything's a dead end.
Wow.
Until it gets back.
Your greed has trapped you in the dungeon.
It did. All right, there we go. Perfect. I'll move there.
Okay.
So.
Val, it's your turn.
No.
No, no golem. Oh, the golem.
The golem. Dreidel, dreidel, dreidel.
Why didn't the golem show up to attack the wizard?
Well, the golem still technically works for the wizard.
Are you attacking him?
Yeah.
So he's still crazy.
Well, the wizard
golem
is suffering from madness.
Mike, do you have a might of like six, eight?
No, I have five.
Okay, so take one physical damage. Your choice. Might or speed. And it is now Val's turn. I assume you want to move three in the direction of.
One, two, three.
Oh, so close.
Bless America.
All right. Okay, back to Ronnie's turn. You like to surrogate for her? I think you guys got this.
We do have this. Different explorer, Ruby, think, just for funsies?
Yeah, why not?
Sure, we're going to go explore the street.
Trash pile!
Event card, please.
All calls come flood. Back to life.
What's that sound?
Flash flood the trash pile. That's going to be okay.
Every adventure on the catacomb level must attempt a might roll.
Oh, come on.
What's that sound?
What's he got to do?
He has to attempt a might roll.
Okay, do a might roll. What's right. his target?
Man, tears up. Funny god.
Four better is your best option.
All right.
Now, this is adventurous, so the golem's not affected, I assume?
No, well, he can't breathe or anything.
Well, this is actually being swept away.
Five, six.
You're good. You hold on. You're fine.
What happened?
Oh, flash flood.
Flash flood. Water comes pouring through.
Flash flood, right.
All right, Chris?
What the hell? I like
oh, I didn't go.
You gonna go explore a room?
Sure, why not? We'll go there. Another street.
All right. Boom! Waterfront.
I get another an event card.
Catacombs catch on fire.
Where rat bite? You look down and see a fat, horrid-looking rat scamper away as you notice.
Fat whore? What?
What?
Horrid.
Oh, sorry.
Horrid.
It is water skate.
Looking rat scamper away as you notice the pain in your foot, you suddenly don't feel so well. You've been infected with lycanthropy. Keep this card in front of you.
All
right, you're a werewolf.
Were rat. I lose one sanity, one knowledge, I gain one might, and one speed.
Okay, if you're not a werepanda, I'm
And does something stuff. Happen other than that, or?
Oh, I get other kinds of fun stuff there. If you inflict physical damage to an adventurer on your tile with an attack, you may choose to also infect them with lycanthropy. If you do, they lose one knowledge, one sanity, and gain one might, one speed. They can then infect other adventurers using the same rules.
If you choose...
Well, I think it's like
I can go give you guys lycanthropy if you like.
The villain would do it. Chris, your turn.
It's sort of an advantage.
What doors do I have?
Where are you at? You're the purple guy?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What's your speed?
Five.
If you go into the yellow mold, you might take a little damage.
I'm going through the arm guy, but I wouldn't do that.
You get inner chamber over here.
Door here, door here,
nope.
Door here.
Nope.
There's a door here.
There's one over there.
You want a building
door
tile?
Here, door here.
Let me tell you why you don't want to go there.
Oh, there's also a street or a building tile. Your choice.
Oh, actually, that should be turned around. You said we can maximize building, right?
No, it doesn't have to match.
Well, you said that we want a building. We want to maximize buildings, right?
No, I just, what I meant was that maximize the amount of places you could keep building out, not buildings.
Oh, sorry, I misunderstood.
So,
that works better.
Okay, that's fine.
Building
then, Chris?
Where are you going? I guess I know that the golem is fighting him and not coming.
Yep.
Yeah.
Sure, I'll go over to the street or whatever. All
right.
The building.
The weapon shop.
The weapon shop.
Which connects, by the way, down there.
Yeah.
So now you would have had a way out.
Had a way out.
He gets an item.
And you get an item. Probably a sword or something.
Crossbow.
Ooh.
The ideal tool when you want to commit violence from a safe distance. You may use this weapon to attack with speed instead of might. Ooh, that's actually nice for me.
Yeah.
Roll one additional die on your speed attack. Roll a maximum 8. You may use this weapon to attack anyone in the same pile or within line of sight. I wanted to kill him. No, I'm kidding.
So you could shoot, like, anywhere you have line of sight.
If you attack someone on a tile, on another tile, you don't take damage.
Right. Just
you can't use another weapon while using this one.
Yep. All right, crossbow Joe. All right, Mike, your turn. Probably going to be the last turn.
Last turn.
Any good stuff over there?
Well, all you have to do is get...
You don't want to make a new...
I have a wear on, but...
Now if I move 4 away and make a run, only 4th move.
Yes, you could.
I'm going to go upstairs.
That's 1, 2... 3.
I guess 3, 4. All
right.
Okay.
Go to a new room.
Oh, you could go to a building if you want.
You can see what you're going to do.
Because far enough away.
If I turn my end at that 3 movement and that golem will
go. Right. That's true. Okay. Golem's turn. He's going to come up the steps.
1, 2, 3.
Actually, no, he'll go here.
He'll go here.
Can't.
Oh. There's... No, no, no door.
Oh, there's a door.
That's why I was like,
is this 1 for him?
Yes. Yeah.
1.
That's 1 already. 2.
2.
So this would be the closest, because you can get to them. Right. Well, I mean, you can't, but that's the closest.
It's the same.
Oh. Well, that's the same distance.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, well then I'll roll. I'll roll. High, he goes this way. Low, he goes that way.
Right. Well, what's high? 0, 1?
Yeah, 0, 1.
Well, you got 2s. How about 1 this way, 2 that way?
Okay.
There's 2 of us this way.
1. So he went the right way.
There we go.
And it doesn't really matter because... I assume you're going to take 1 step and win the game? Bam!
But the mold affects them.
Yes.
I would say the winning condition happens first. So, congratulations, you won.
We win!
Yay!
Victory!
So that was Baldur. That was Betrayal at Baldur's Gate. Whee! Thank you for watching.
Pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, yeah. What'd you guys think, by the way?
That worked pretty well.
Yeah. Did you like the game? Would you play again?
I would play again.
Yep.
I wouldn't buy it, but I don't
know. Maybe not with him, though. Yeah.
Okay, well, thanks, guys. Appreciate it. All right, see you next time. Yep. Cut. Unless you get